हेलो स्टूडेंट, आई एम योर एपीडी मैम। टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग। नाउ बिफोर इट लेट्स सी अ पिक्चर। ओके, नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, कैन यू एक्सप्लेन दिस पिक्चर इन अ वन वर्ड? नाउ थिंक अबाउट इट। ओके, now the common thing is that is the energy. Now see here, different types of energy are depicted, that is solar energy, wind energy. Okay, so the common thing is the energy. Now tell me, this energy is important for our living beings or our body? What do you think? If yes, then why this energy is required? Now see here, our body is actually a production house where different types of systems are present which are involved in the production of different types of things. That means there are different types of biochemical processes in our body for our survival. So to execute this type of biochemical processes, we need the energy. But what is the source of energy, or how the energy is produced in our body? What do you think? Let's see. So today we will going to discuss the energy production in our body. Okay, let's see. Now at first, see this picture. Now in this picture, what is depicted? It's a production house in which there are different types of machineries and many workers. And how they work? See here, there are several types of machines. First one, machine 1, machine 2, machine 3, and the machine 4. And there are many workers: worker A, worker B, worker C. But in this production house, what is actually happening? Now see here, worker A collecting some raw materials like that, and it's hand over to worker B, and worker B actually arrange them and delivery it to the machine 2. And after that, in the machine 2, it's sorting the things, and again it's hand over to worker B, where worker B deliver it to machine 3. And in this machine 3, the worker C actually produce something, that is the products. Okay, now after the production of the required product, it's delivered to machine 4 for the packing. Now like this production house, our body has also a energy production house. Let's compare it with our body system. Okay, now see here, the machine 1 is actually the respiratory system, okay, which collects the raw materials from the environment. So we get the machine 1 as the respiratory system. And after that, the worker B, who actually delivered the raw materials to the machine 2. And here the worker 2 is actually the red blood cell, okay, RBC. And here the worker 1 or worker A, who collect the raw materials, is our lungs and other structures that are involved in the respiratory system, okay. Now the machine 2, who actually sorting these things. Now here in our body, the machine 2 is actually our heart, okay. And next the machine 3, where actually the desired product is produced. Now here the machine 3 is actually the cell, our basic unit of our body, our functional and structural unit, okay. And inside the machine 3, here the worker C or worker 3 is involved. And actually the worker C or worker 3 is the mitochondria and its enzymes, who actually involved in the energy production, okay. And again the machine 4, where actually after production of the product they are delivered. And here the machine 4 and machine 1 in our body is the same, that means our respiratory system. That means our respiratory system collects the raw material from the environment, and again after the production of the products, what is necessary is remain in our body, and the unnecessary products or the byproducts are again released to the environment through this respiratory system. So this is all about the energy production house of our body, okay. But what are the raw materials and the products in this energy production process in our body? Now see here, the first and main raw material, that is the glucose. And what is the source of glucose? It is the food. Now all of you know, after taking up the food material, complex food material, the digestive enzymes break down it into the smallest one, that means in the form of glucose. And after that, these glucose molecules are absorbed and assimilated in the cell. So first the source of energy is the food or the glucose. The next raw material is the oxygen, and we take it from the environment, atmosphere, okay. But what are the products? The first product and the main product is the energy, ATP, adenosine triphosphate. In all the biological system, the energy is stored in this form, ATP, okay. And there are several byproducts. The first one is the carbon dioxide, which is harmful for our body, so we have to release it again into the atmosphere. And this carbon dioxide is again reutilized by the plants for making their food in the process of photosynthesis, okay. And the another product is the water molecule, which is also released in our from our body. So this is all about the raw material and products of our energy production house, okay. Now this energy production process is known as the respiration. Now respiration is the process through which from the food material, in presence of oxygen molecules, the energy molecule is produced, okay. Now let's see the process of energy production. Now again we come back to the first picture, okay, our production house. Now see here what happened. At the first step, very first step, the worker A actually collecting the raw material and it is delivered to the machine 1. Okay, and after that these raw material are delivered to the machine 2 with the help of worker B. That means this is the first step, that is the second step. And after the sorting with the help of worker B again, the raw materials are delivered to the machine 3. Okay, now that is the third step. And after the delivery inside the machine 3, with the help of worker C, our product is produced. That means that is the step 4. So step 1, delivery or collecting of the raw materials with the help of worker A and machine 1. And after that, delivery of the raw material to the machine 2 with the help of worker B. And again with the worker help of the worker B, the raw materials are delivered to the machine 3. And then inside the machine 3 with the help of worker C, our product is produced. So total 4 steps are there. Okay, now let's compare it. Now see here, at first the source of glucose is food which is already present in the cell by the process of digestion, okay, and the assimilation. And then the next raw material, that means the oxygen molecules which is present in the atmosphere, is taken by our respiratory system with the help of worker A or worker 1, that means here the lungs. Okay, so first of all our respiratory system or the lungs collect the oxygen molecules from the atmosphere. So that is the first step. And after that, this oxygen molecule is delivered to the machine 2. Now here machine 2 is the heart. That means there is a worker B, and here the worker B or worker 2 is our RBC, red blood cell. Now these red blood cell molecules or cells actually binds with the oxygen molecules and delivery it to the heart. And then again heart, by pumping the blood with the help of RBC, delivery it to the machine 3, that means in our cell or tissue. So that is the second and that is the third step. And after the delivery of the oxygen molecules inside the cell, with the help of enzymes present in the mitochondria, the energy molecules is produced. And as a byproduct, we get the carbon dioxide molecules. And again the carbon dioxide molecules with the help of RBC come back to the lungs, and then with the help of lungs and the respiratory system, it again released to the atmosphere. So these are the process. Now the first step, where we take the oxygen molecules from the atmosphere and release the carbon dioxide molecule to the atmosphere, this first physical step or mechanical step is known as the external respiration or breathing. Okay, and after that, with the help of RBC and blood and involvement of the circulatory system, these oxygen molecules is delivered to the cell, and again after the production of the carbon dioxide molecule, it's again delivered to the lungs. Now this transporting channel, that means presence of RBC and carrying of the gases, this step is known as the internal respiration. Okay, and another and the final type of respiration where actually the energy is produced is the cellular respiration. Now see here, that is the cell. Cell is our structural and functional unit, and all of you know that cell has a plasma membrane that surrounds the cell, and inside the plasma membrane there is a solution like structure, that is the cytosol or cytoplasm. Here the eolus structure, and inside the cytoplasm there are several types of cell organelles. All of you know that. First nucleus, mitochondria, Golgi body, okay, like that. Now here the mitochondria is the main site of energy production. Now what happened? The glucose molecule, which is already present in the cell for the absorption of the food molecules, and then the RBC molecules through the internal respiration delivered the oxygen molecule inside the cell. So first of all, the glucose molecule converted into the pyruvic acid or pyruvate, and this step is known as glycolysis, and this glycolysis is happened in the cytoplasm, only the yellowish portion. And after the formation of the pyruvic acid or pyruvate, this acid is delivered to the mitochondria, and inside the mitochondria here many enzymes are present which actually involved in the oxidation. Okay, now these enzymes acts on the pyruvic acid and the energy molecule is produced. Clear? And as a result, we get the carbon dioxide molecule and the water molecule. And this is the main product. And after the formation of the carbon dioxide molecule, this carbon dioxide molecule is again delivered to the lung with the help of RBC. And after the delivery of the CO2 into the lung, this lung releases it to the atmosphere. And inside the cell, the production of the energy, this step is known as cellular respiration. So respiration are three types, the steps. First one external or breathing, next one internal, and third one is the cellular respiration. So overall the step is like that. We take the oxygen molecule from the atmosphere, breathe in, and after that this oxygen molecule is delivered to the cell, where the oxygen molecule oxidizes the glucose molecule and produce the energy, water and the carbon dioxide molecule. And after that, this carbon dioxide molecule again comes to the lungs and breathe out. And this bluish part where we breathe in and breathe out, that is the breathing. It's a physical or mechanical process, and where the oxygen or carbon dioxide is exchanged between this blue and the pink color, that is the internal respiration. And inside this pink area the energy production is happening, that means that is the cellular respiration. So this is all about the steps or the process of the energy production. Okay. Now there are several types of respiration depending upon the organisms and the atmosphere. Okay. Now let's see. Now see here, the glucose molecule is converted into the pyruvate or pyruvic acid, and this step is happened into the cytoplasm of the cell. And after that, this pyruvate molecule is converted into the energy in three ways. The first of all that we already discussed, in presence of oxygen molecule, and it is happen inside the mitochondria, and here we get a largest amount of energy, that means 38 ATP. Okay. Now where the oxygen molecule is present, that means type C, is actually the aerobic respiration. Okay. Now the next one, where the oxygen molecule is absent, that means this type of process is found in some microorganisms and some fungus like yeast. And here, as the oxygen molecule is absent, we get lesser energy. Only from this step the amount of energy is produced, and it's about 2 ATP. So see here 38, here 2. So it's very less. Now this type of respiration where oxygen molecule is absent is known as anaerobic respiration. And the another type, which is very common in our human body, now all of you experienced in this case, now after a heavy exercise or heavy physical processes, our muscles become very stiff, and we feel some pains. Now that is the muscle cramp. And why this type of muscle cramp is happen? Because after doing heavy and long period of exercise in the muscle cells, there is a deficiency of oxygen molecule. And as the oxygen molecule is lack for a certain period, the pyruvic acid is converted into the lactic acid, and due to the storage of the lactic acid, we feel such type of stiffness and pain. And here also the energy production is lesser than the aerobic respiration. So there are three types of respiration: aerobic, anaerobic, and lactic acid formation. Now see, that is the yeast which is used in the cake and beverage formation. And the anaerobic respiration performed by the yeast is also known as the fermentation. Here the alcohol is produced. Now see here, in the aerobic respiration, CO2 is produced, water is produced, here ethanol or any type of alcohol is produced instead of H2O molecule. Okay. Now this is the muscle cramp, this one due to the lactic acid formation. And if we feel this such type of muscle cramp, then we have to massage the cramp area. And if we give a hot bath, water bath, then we get relief, because it's increase the supply of the oxygen at that affected area. So the lactic acid which is formed in the muscle cells is again converted into the carbon dioxide and the water molecule. So there will be no lactic acid, and we get relief from the cramp or the stiffness. So this is all about your respiration, the first part of your respiration chapter. And in the next class we will discuss the respiratory system and its detailed process, how the respiration is occurred in our body. And it's time to your self-assessment. Solve these 10 questions and take your knowledge. Thank you.